stars glow for you. Go see the world, cause it's all so brand new. So close your eyes, cause your future's ready to shine. It's just a matter of time before we learn.
So today we are going to do the Pledge of Allegiance in sign language. Okay guys, here we go. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Let's sing!
Shout your name until the whole world
such a good job dancing, do not have a seat. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the Books of the Bible song together. Okay, are you guys ready? Here we go.
These are the books of the Bible. Whoa, whoa. Wonderful books of the Bible.
Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, and Job, Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, and Hosea, Joel and Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, and Job, Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, and Hosea, Joel and Miss Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me. Of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me.
These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. Books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books.
Okay, so that's all we're going to learn for today. So I need everyone to fold their hands and close their eyes and please repeat after me. Dear Jesus, thank you for this day. Thank you for my family. Please help us to follow you. And everyone says, amen, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.
Hey guys, who's ready for calendar? Does anyone know what day of the week it is today? Today is Thursday. So we have to put today is on our Thursday. So what day was yesterday? Yesterday was Wednesday. Very good. And then if yesterday was Wednesday and today is Thursday, what day will tomorrow be? It's going to be Friday. Very good. So we're going to put tomorrow will be Friday. Can you guys sing nice and loud? Today is Thursday. Today is Thursday. Yesterday was Wednesday. Yesterday was Wednesday. Tomorrow will be Friday. Tomorrow will be Friday. Today is Thursday. Today is Thursday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. These are the days of the week. Good job singing. Do you remember what month we're in? We're still in the month of May. Now, yesterday was the 20th. Do you guys know what comes after 20? 21. So we're going to start on our ones column. We went from 0 to 1 because 1 comes next. And then there's a 2 in our tens column. So it would be 2 10 bars and then 1 red one from the beep stair. That's what 21 looks like. So we say that today is Thursday, May 21st, 2020. Very good. Let's sing our months. January, February, March, and April, May, June, July, and August, September, October, November, December. These are the months of the year. Good job, guys. All right, don't forget to check your weather today. You can do it in the morning or in the afternoon or at night. Check what the weather feels like and check what it looks like, because it's important to use both of those. It's important to use our eyes, and it's important to use our senses and see what it feels like, all right? And have fun today, guys. Bye.
Hello, guys. So yesterday, I had you guys all guess if the hippo was a boy hippo or a girl hippo. Are you guys ready to find out? Okay, drum roll please. It was a boy hippo that was born. How many of you guys guessed that the hippo was a boy? Good job. Now I'm going to show you a picture in the next slide of the baby hippo. It looks a little different than I thought it would look, but here it is. Isn't he so cute, guys? I wonder what they're going to name him. Hello, everyone. So today, what we want you to do is we want you to try to find a line, just like our Montessori line that's around the classroom. You guys may find a line on your driveway. You may find lines on the sidewalk. Or you may have lines in your house on the floor. What we want you to do is walk heel to toe, heel to toe. And if you think that's too easy, maybe try carrying a bucket of water as you do this, just like we would do in the classroom. Do you guys think you can do it? We know you can.
Today we have a fun game to play. It's a build a pizza game. So here on our card, it says how many pepperonis, how many tomatoes we have to put on our pizza. So we have to count these things out. So let's start right here. We need to put on our pizza 2 tomatoes. All right, so we have 1 tomato. 2 tomatoes. Okay, next we have to put 4 mushrooms on our pizza. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 mushrooms on our pizza. What do we have next? 3. We need to put on 3 black olives. All right, you guys help me count. 1, 2, 3. Next, we have 2 pepperonis. Let's count out 2 pepperonis for our pizza. 1, 2. Okay, now we have to put on 1 green pepper. Let's count out 1. 1. Okay, last we have to put on 3 onions. Let's count out 3. 1, 2, 3. Good job making a pizza with me. Today we are going to review our shapes. So when I point to the shape, you tell me what it is. Are you ready? Let's start. What shape is this? Square. The square has 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. Square. What shape is this? Rectangle. The rectangle has 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. The rectangle, though, has 2 sides that are longer and 2 that are shorter. Rectangle. What shape is this? Triangle. The triangle has 1, 2, 3 sides. Triangle. What shape is this? Oval. Very good. The oval is round. Oval. What shape is this? Star. Very good. What shape is this? A diamond. The diamond has 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. Diamond. What shape is this? Very good, a hexagon. The hexagon has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides. Hexagon. What shape is this? Circle. Very good. And the circle is round. Circle. What shape is this? Very good. A pentagon. The pentagon has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. Pentagon. Great job.
Hello, toddlers. We're going to do another work together. Now, this work right here is on our language shelf, and this is called the naming objects work. Before we are able to read or match or rhyme or do any other language skill, we first have to be able to look at an object and be able to say its name. So let's do that together. I want you guys to tell me the name of the objects I hold up. What is this? This is an orange. Do you guys like eating oranges? I do. Let's see what this object is. What are these? Are these socks? Are you guys wearing socks right now on your feet? What color are your socks? What is this object? This is a ball. What kind of ball is this? This is a soccer ball. What is this? This is a cup. What color is my cup? It's blue. And the last object I have, what is this? This is a baby. Baby. And the baby's wearing red and white clothes. Okay, guys, let's go over the objects one more time. We have our baby. We have our cup. We have a soccer ball. We have some socks. And we have our orange. Great job naming objects today, guys.
All right, so let's read the book. Bear Sees Colors. Mouse and Bear are walking. They are chitter-chatter talking. So much for them to do. And the bear sees blue. Blue flowers by the trail. Blueberries, blue pail. Blue, blue everywhere. Can you spy blue with Bear? Along the trail hops Hare. Howdy ho there, Mouse and Bear. Hare points up ahead and the bear sees red. Red blossoms, red cherries, red juicy raspberries. Red, red everywhere. Can you spy red with Bear? Badger's at the pond with his old galoshes on. Look there, Badger bellows, and the bear sees yellow. Drippy, sticky, oh so yummy honeycombs with yellow honey. Yellow, yellow everywhere. Can you find it just like Bear? Goofers out with Mole. They are on a little stroll. Bear spots them by the stream, and the bear sees green. Green mint for making tea. Green and tasty sweet peas. Green, green everywhere. Can you spy green with Bear? Raven, owl, and wren lay a picnic in the glen. The friends all gather round, and the friends see brown. Chocolate cake, brown and sweet, brown cookies, such a treat. Brown eyes, brown hair, friendly, fluffy, brown bear. Colors, colors everywhere. Can you find colors just like Bear?
Hi guys, so for today, we're gonna keep practicing our after. What comes after different numbers? And remember, we can use our arrow that points to what comes next. So the first way we're gonna practice is I'm going to write a number on here, and I want you to tell me what comes after. So what comes after our number 4? 5. 5 comes after 4. What comes after our number 1? Number 2. Very good. That's what comes after. That's what comes next. What comes after our number 6? Our number 7. Very good. 7 is the number you say after 6. You say it next. What comes after our number 9? Number 10. Very good. And that's when we start our teens. In our tens family. What comes after our number 11? 12 does. Very good. What comes after our number 18? Number 19. Very good. 19 is the one that you say after you say 18. What number comes after 23? Our number 24. Very nice. Now here's a bigger number. What number comes after 57? Our number 58. Very good. So remember, I want you guys to practice your afters, having someone either write it or show you a card without showing you what numbers are around it. And then do you remember our other way of practicing, just like we did with before, but now with after? We're going to practice by looking at numbers. So which one of these comes after the other one? Our 3 comes after 0. What about these ones? We have 2 and 6. Which one comes after? Which one do you say next? We say 6 after we say 2. That's what comes next. What about these numbers? We have 4 and 8. What comes after? Which one do you say next? You say 8 after we say 4. Very good. And let's try some bigger numbers. What about these? We have 21 and 26. What comes after? Our 26. Good job. 26 is the number we say after we say 21. There are some numbers in between, but this is the one that comes after if you were putting them in order. What number comes after? We have 22 and 32. Which one comes after? Our 32 comes after. If you were writing them out, there would be a lot of numbers in between, but 32 is the one that comes after 22. And that's how I want you to practice your afters today. Remember, you can either have someone write it down, or you can find numbers around your house, or look at the number on your mailbox and say what comes after. And then have someone write down 2 numbers. They might not be in order. They might have a lot of numbers that go in between, like these 2. They'll have a lot of numbers that go in between these numbers. But look at the 2 numbers and say, which one would come after? Okay? I want you to practice all your afters today and have fun with it, guys. Bye.
Hi, friends. Today you are going to learn about the simple machine. There are so many things around you based on the physics. Let's learn. These are sample of simple machines. You see the wedge, pulley, inclined planes. Here you see screw, wheel and axle, and levers. All these are used in the daily life.
So let's take another look of our simple machine, the inclined plane, in action. Instead of using this 1,000-gram weight, I'm going to use this four-wheeler, this quad. What if I had to load this quad into the back of this trailer? Do you think I could actually lift that machine up and move it back into the trailer? I don't think I could.
Today, we have a problem. Do you guys see this four-wheeler right here? Well, I really want to go four-wheeling. But in order to go four-wheeling, I first need to get the four-wheeler into the truck before I can go to this place that I can four-wheel. Now, I tried really, really, really hard lifting the four-wheeler up into the truck all by myself, but I'm just not strong enough. Do you guys know what simple machine we could use to help make it easier? Let's find out.
But I could use our simple machine, the inclined plane, to make it a whole lot easier. So let's see if we can use some inclined planes to help us load our four-wheeler. Put my inclined planes up on my trailer and see if we can move our quad up the trailer instead of lifting it, and it works. That job was made a whole lot easier using inclined planes. Now, inclined planes may seem very simple, but we can do really cool things with inclined planes. Take a look at this. I have my inclined plane, but watch what happens when I wrap that inclined plane around something. Get it started here. I'm going to wrap this. And I want you to see what happens when I take that inclined plane and wrap it up. What does it look like I'm forming? Well, see the blue line, the top of my inclined plane? It looks an awful lot like a screw. We've zoomed in so that you can see that a screw is nothing more than an inclined plane wrapped around a piece of metal. Inclined planes and simple machines are all around us. See if you can find your own examples of simple machines anywhere.
Hi, boys and girls. Did you guys make your puppets yesterday? I hope so. So, today, what I want you guys to do is put on your own puppet show. Do you guys think you can do that? What you're gonna need is two chairs, a blanket, and your puppet. Have fun today, guys. Hello guys, today we're gonna talk about the steps that we need to take so that we can go swimming. How many of you guys like to go swimming? I know I do. Now, if I really, really wanted to go swimming, what's something I would need to do first? First, I would need to change into my swimming suit. Then, what do I need to put on my skin so it protects me from the sun? Sunscreen, you're right. I would not only need to put on my body, but make sure it goes on my face as well. After I have my swimsuit on and after I have sunscreen on, what would I need to grab to protect my eyes so I can see underwater? I would need my goggles. After I had my swimsuit on, sunscreen on, and I found my goggles, we still need to grab one more thing. Because after we're all done swimming, we're really, really wet, right? So what do I need to keep me dry when I'm all done swimming? I need a towel. Once I have my swimsuit on, my sunscreen on, I found my goggles, and I have my beach towel, I am ready to go swimming. I hope it keeps getting warmer outside so we can go swimming every day. How many of you guys have already gone swimming or played with water balloons? I know some of you have. I hope today, guys, you remember that in order to go swimming, there are many steps. Let's count the steps together. First, we need to get our swimsuit on. Second, we need to put sunscreen on our body and our face. Then we need to find our goggles. And then we need to grab our towel. That's four steps to get outside and go swimming. Okay guys, it's time for you guys to see how many signs you can do without watching me. Here is the song, Do the Signs That You Know, and I'm going to teach you more of it tomorrow.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are
see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. Yeah, you never stop. Yeah, I can.
Girls, it is Music Thursday, and today we are going to do a song that I think you guys will remember. Are you guys ready?
Sing the hello song. This is such a happy day. Our music friends have come to play with Mozart Mouse and Beethoven.
We are going to be playing Guess This Song. So I want you guys to guess the song that I play. Now remember, say the solfege names with me, and we're going to do the hand sides with our hand. Okay, so we are going to start on do. So get your hand ready for do. Do, do, sol, sol. Now, if you guys said, that wasn't Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, that was the ABCs, or that was Ba Ba Black Sheep, you are also right, because all three of those songs have the same tune. ABCs, Ba Ba Black Sheep, and Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Isn't that pretty neat? Good job, you guys, and I'll see you later. Bye.
Hello, boys and girls. It's time to read our book, The BFG. But before we do, we've been talking about acronyms. And that's when you take the first letter of each of the words and you put them together. So you don't have to say big, friendly, giant over and over again. We just say BFG. And yesterday, I talked to you guys about another acronym that many of you guys are familiar with. And that's the word NASA. Did you know each of those letters, N-A-S-A, stand for something? Just like in our book, the BFG. And I told you guys yesterday, and I asked, could you guys figure out what those four letters stand for? Did any of you guys do it? NASA stands for the National Aeronautics and Spaceship Administration. Isn't that so cool? But how many of you guys would want to say that over and over again? That's a really long name. That's why they created an acronym, NASA, N-A-S-A. That's pretty cool. Okay, it's time to read our book, and we're on the next chapter, The Frob Scottle and Whiz Popper. I wonder what this will be about. By now, Sophie was beginning to feel not only extremely hungry, but very thirsty as well. Had she been at home, she would have finished her breakfast long ago. Are you sure there's nothing else to eat around here except those disgusting smelly snozcumbers? She asked. Not even a fizzwinkle, answered the BFG. In that case, may I please have some water? She said. Water? The BFG said, frowning mightily. What is water? We drink it, Sophie said. What do you drink? We drink Frobscottle, announced the BFG. All giants is drinking Frobscottle. Is it as nasty as snozcumbers? Sophie asked. Nasty, cried the BFG. Never is it nasty. Frobscottle is sweet and jumbly. He got up from the chair and went to a second huge cupboard. He opened it and took out a glass bottle that must have been at least 6 feet tall. The liquid inside was pale green and the bottle was half full. Here is Frobscottle, he cried, holding up the bottle proud and high, as though it contained some rare special juice. This is the frizzy, delicious Frobscottle, he shouted. He gave it a shake and the green stuff began to fizz like mad. But look, it's fizzing the wrong way, Sophie cried. And indeed it was. The bubbles, instead of traveling up and bursting to the surface, were shooting downwards and bursting through the bottom. Do you guys see how the bubbles are going down? They're getting bigger as they go down. Usually they get bigger as they go up. A pale green, frothy frizz was forming at the bottom of the bottle. What on earth is you meaning the wrong way? Asked the BFG. In our fizzy drink, Sophie said, the bubbles always go up and burst at the top. Upwards is the wrong way, cried the BFG. You mustn't ever be having bubbles go upwards. That is the most flood-washing rubbish I've ever heard. Why do you say that? Sophie asked. You was asking me why? Cried the BFG, waving enormous bottle around as though he was conducting an orchestra. You is actually meaning to tell me that you cannot see why it is a scrotty mistake to have bubbles flying up instead of down? You said it was a flush bunking. Now you're saying it's scrotty. Which is it? Sophie asked politely. Both, cried the BFG. It is a flush bunking and a scratty mistake to let the bubbles go upward. If you can't see why, you must be as quacky as a duck hound. By Ringo, your hot head must be so full of frog squiddles and buzz wagglers. I is frightened if I know how you can think at all. Why shouldn't the bubbles go upward? Sophie asked. I will explain, the BFG said. But tell me first, what name is you calling your Frobscottle by? One is Coke, Sophie said. Another is Pepsi. There are lots of them, like root beer and orange soda. And all of the bubbles are going up? Asked the BFG. They all go up, Sophie said. Castrosterous, cried the BFG. Upgoing bubbles is a castrosferous disastrophe. Will you please tell me why, Sophie said? If you will listen carefully, I will try to explain. but your brain is so full of bug wiffles, I doubt you will ever understand. I will do my best, Sophie said patiently. Very well then, when you was drinking this kooky drink of yours, said the BFG, I think he meant Coke, it is going straight down into your tummy. Is that right or is it left? It's right, Sophie said. And the bubbles is going into your tummy, right or left? Right again, Sophie said. And the bubbles is fizzing upward? Of course, Sophie said. Which means, the BFG said, that they will all come out swish-whiffling up your throat and out your mouth and make a foulsome, belchy burp. And that is where we're going to stop today, guys. You guys are going to come back tomorrow to figure out if the giants don't burp, what happens when they drink too much soda? I'll see you later, guys, and hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye.
So